Hey guys, and welcome to Black Games, and today I'm going to be playing the last episode of Jurassic Park, episode 4. I'm really excited, so let's play this motherfucking shit.
What's out there? What did this to him?
They're called Troodon Pectinodon. They were meant to be euthanized, but—
What? You let them out?
No! I kept them in quarantine for study. I thought they may have been leaving the pen somehow, but I wasn't certain.
We knew about those damn creatures all along. While we were out there, exposed,
she didn't really know.
Looking for our pilot.
Billy, wait!
We were nearly killed by one of our own men.
It wasn't
probably
a fault.
Bitten by one of those things, just like Decaf. Who knows where his catatonic body is now? Both our teams are dead. Oscar is dead. All because of your dinosaurs. All because of you.
You need to calm your tits down, man.
Billy, listen, I get it. You're angry, but we need Laura alive. She's the only one here familiar with what we're dealing with.
And what good does it do us if she keeps that intel to herself? Anyway, this witch is a liar. She's lied to all of us. Put me in the direct line of danger to protect her agenda and her precious freak show.
Agenda?
What else is she hiding?
Please, if I knew sooner,
oh, shut it.
Nima, help. Lied to all of us.
How did she lie? Because she wouldn't tell us information without knowing the facts?
She could have speculated.
No.
How?
Speculating could have led us into even more danger.
So what, I'm the enemy? I'm the bad guy here? I'm just trying to open your eyes! I'm trying to show you the truth and bring someone to account for it!
Bad guy.
You are the bad guy. I saw that Oscar had changed his ways, but you become everything I thought he was, and you are about to add murderer to that list.
Oh, come on! This isn't on me! It's time for her to take responsibility!
Gary, help.
Just it, Billy. She's not the one responsible. This falls on the shoulders of Hammond and InGen, and now we're all suffering for it.
Still.
Billy, let her go. We need every able mind and body we can get.
All she has to say is, it's my fault. It's my fault. Come on, Doc, let me hear it.
No, it wasn't.
Say it!
Don't say it. God damn it!
There. It wasn't so difficult, was it? Your friends may have saved you here. At least I got the truth out of her. You want her alive? You got it.
Jesus fucking Christ, he's crazy.
Just mark my words. She will save just one of those animals before she lifts a finger to help you. Now, everyone make themselves useful. I've got to tend to Decaf.
Look, yeah. We can't stay here long. Let's just give Billy a minute and see if we can find anything useful. A way out, even.
Okay, we'll do a sweep of the room and check in when we're done. Agreed?
Damn.
I think they're empty. They're still heavy, though.
Use it as a weapon. Let's see, a shovel.
Huele excremento.
Disgusting shovel. okay. Can we have a look outside?
I don't see anything. Maybe it's clear.
Maybe not.
I hate being trapped on here like a rat.
Good information.
Locked. I don't want to get stuck in a vent with a dinosaur. Besides, there's blood everywhere.
Yeah.
Ow! Mm. Hot!
Nothing much. Oh. That's dead.
A flare kit. This might come in handy.
Yeah. Let's go to... Ew.
Billy, we should cover decaf. I don't want Jess to see this.
Yeah.
Oh, I can talk to her?
Are you okay?
Jess, hon, leave him alone.
Sorry. I won't ask again.
Just great. It's locked. Anyone happen to have a key?
No.
What about this grate? It looks big enough for everyone.
And it looks like it's heading in the right direction.
This tunnel looks tall enough for everyone. Maybe we should go this way.
Jess, stand back from the grate. You don't know what's down there.
I'm just trying to help.
What the fuck?
I know, Jess. I just can't keep my attention on everything at hand, plus you.
Damn, don't
be
so mean.
Such a burden.
Let's go to her.
Nemo, what can you remember about that animal that bit you?
I didn't see it when it attacked. It went by so fast. It was dark. After it bit me, I became confused, like I'd been drugged. I remember there were many of them. They had glowing eyes.
Glowing eyes?
Yeah. Like ojos de lobo.
Like what?
These Troodon. What else can you tell me about them?
Well, they're nocturnal. They're intelligent, like raptors, but they don't hunt like them. They envenomate with a single bite, then back off. Stalk their prey. Their teeth are serrated and retain saliva, and the saliva is saturated with a toxin.
Nemo's bite. It was from a Troodon?
Yes, definitely.
We should go.
Leave the door alone. We're not going back out that way.
What?
Why not?
Because we aren't backtracking, and those damn creatures could still be out there.
Okay. What the hell am I supposed to do? Whatever.
We should get moving.
Yeah, are you ready?
Totally.
This is not the time for grieving. We have to move.
Maybe we should...
She's right.
What's that? What is it?
Did you find something?
No, nothing. Is everyone ready?
What about decaf?
I took care of that.
How?
It looked like you took something off him. And if he has something that will help us...
I didn't find anything. I took his dog tags.
Really? You took something else?
Insurance doesn't pay out to his family unless his dog tags are returned. Satisfied?
Oh, you took that too.
Sorry for pushing.
Jesus.
Should we bring him with us?
Why bother? He's already buried.
Ice cold.
Look, I know where his body is. We're not equipped to transport it. Hopefully, we can retrieve his remains when this is all over. All right, listen up. Everything that just happened, bygones, understand? Doc, tell me again about the phones.
According to the terminal in my lab, the marine exhibit phones are still connected to the transceiver. The visitor center phones
are... Too far away, okay? And we can get to the exhibit through the tunnels?
They're all interconnected. I think I can still find...
The answer is yes. Thank you. All right, we all have the same priorities here now. We get to this marine exhibit and find the phone. We get another chopper in the air to lift us out from there.
How are we gonna get there? Troodon could still be out there.
We aren't equipped to treat any more bites. We have to-
Shh.
I will not be shushed.
The door.
Oh no.
They're coming through the vent!
Oh my god, for Halo. For Halo, man.
Come on!
Huh? Ew.
Going past the door.
No. The vent.
Jerry, get that grate open!
I'm on it. I need something to break the lock.
We'll find out something!
The air tank!
What?
Use the air tank! It's heavy and sturdy!
Heavy and sturdy. Come on. They kind of sound like tigers, don't you think? Damn it! Come on! Yes!
Got it! Let's go!
One more time. Yes. Ugliest. Yes. Ugly as fuck. Oh my god.
Oh no. Which way, Laura?
I don't know where we are anymore. We need to head towards the north.
North is this way. Oh.
Where are we?
Was it one?
We must have taken a wrong turn.
Wrong turn! No, that's horrible. This sound like tigers. Sound exactly like tigers. Right, left, right, left. This time, left.
Wait, the conduit's gone.
Don't stop.
Wait, those are water mains.
Go, follow.
Which way, Laura?
I don't know, Jerry. We must be 40 feet underground.
Don't
I have no
ask
idea
me again.
Where we are.
We can't just sit around with our thumbs up our butts.
I don't hear them anymore. Their behavior seemed territorial. Maybe we're far enough away from the nest that they gave up on us.
We might have outpaced them, but we're not exactly in a secure location. Which way are we heading, Doc?
She doesn't know.
Here. Can you read these?
Maybe. If I can find... Yes. Yes. Okay. We're at a four-way intersection. There are only four such intersections on the plan. Let me just cross-reference these detail labels. Okay, we just have to figure out which intersection we're at. Look around the corridors for any distinguishing features. I'll see if I can eliminate possibilities.
Maybe I can help with the plans. They look pretty simple.
I hope they are. Nope, that doesn't look pretty simple.
There's a ladder on the right, and on the far wall at the end. I see some sort of water tanks at the end of the hall. It looks like the corridor ends in a T intersection.
T intersection. Okay, let's go over here.
There are these two big electrical boxes of some kind on the right.
Two big boxes.
There's a big yellow pipe that goes down a bit on the left and then crosses over to the other side. Está muy oscuro. I can't see a thing down here, Sorkin. Aren't there any lights?
Don't let your night vision get away from you. You'll have to stare at a point down the corridor until your eyes adjust. Try to scan slowly with your eyes.
Scan. Oh wait, it's working.
The tunnel goes straight and then turns to the right. I see two ladders along the left of the tunnel.
Two ladders on the left of the tunnel. Let's go to this guy.
There's a set of water tanks partway down the corridor on the right. There's a big yellow pipe that goes down the left wall and into the floor. I see one ladder at the end of the hallway. This tunnel only goes down a few dozen yards to a dead end.
To a dead end? Okay, I think I know. There's a ladder at the end of the hallway. This one. Two big tanks on the right. This one, this one. I don't have a fucking clue, man. Jesus Christ. Who made this shit? Am I seriously, God?
I'm just gonna cross this one off.
Okay, I hope you're right.
This is like a puzzle for 50 years. I don't know, this ship.
Probably not this one.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I'm just guessing, I don't know. There should be a ladder at the end of the hallway. These two are both ladders. Should be tanks. Two other tanks. In the T section, there should be a tier. These look like the same except. Okay, I'm crossing this
one. I don't think it's this one.
How can you keep them all straight?
I don't know. Good question. So it's probably this one. I'm just guessing.
It could be here.
I guess they all kind of look the same.
Yeah,
okay,
I think
everyone,
so too.
I think I've got it. Are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm positive. We must be here. It's the only one that completely matches our surroundings. Okay, here we are. The desalination plant is here.
We're not that far.
No, we follow this route here. We follow any water lanes or junctions in the direction of convergence. Even still, there's barely any turns. Look, just memorize this route.
No. For helvede, man!
Wow. over!
No.
Jesse!
Jebby!
Don't tell me they ate her! Jesus fucking Christ.
Oh God, Jess! Oh, what have I done? I just left her down there. I have to go find her.
No,
back down there with those monsters? No, Jerry. She needs you safe. Jess is a strong and resourceful girl. She's doing like we are doing. Surviving.
You can't know that. I won't leave her to those animals.
Jerry, look at me. If we go back down there, we won't make it to the bottom of that ladder. The others escaped down the tunnel we were gonna follow. We know where they're going.
The marine exhibit. That's where Laura would take her.
And Yoder is with them.
Oh my God.
Oh God.
If we're going to join them again, that is where we have to go. The quickest way we can.
You're right. We should be able to make better time over land.
Can you get us there?
Sorkin mentioned the desalination plant. That would be near the ocean, right?
Jerry, the whole island is near the ocean.
Right, but we pump seawater in from the lagoon. They must have built the marine exhibit near the waterworks.
Lagoon? I think I know where that is. Let me get my bearings, and we'll figure out how to get there. Por el amor de Dios.
Do you know where we are?
Let me think. It's been so long. This is my first time back on the island in nearly 12 years.
12 years?
Engine has changed it so much.
Nemo,
we don't have
island.
The time.
There's more to it, isn't there? To you, I mean.
Yes. It is very dear to me.
Tell me.
I grew up here, you know?
You lived there?
My people were fishermen. We would make our homes near
if
the
not
water
talk,
during the fishing
fuck.
Season. I love the water. I would swim in the ocean. So far. That's why my father called me Nemo.
I see now. You and your family used to live on this island?
My family, everyone, my whole tribe. This had been our home for thousands of years. I could go anywhere, run in the jungle, climb the trees. These monsters, there was never anything like them on this island before. It was all very peaceful before Injun bought the island from Costa Rica.
What does your name mean?
It means little fish. You know, like the ones that have so many colors.
I didn't realize this island had been inhabited before. Injun moved your people?
They promised us homes and medicine. Education.
They didn't keep their promise.
No.
I guess from your point of view, they did. But the homes were slums and the medicine was extra or half-used or contaminated. We had schools, but no teachers. The island is so different now. I know the island. It's part of me. But when Injun came to the island, important men from Costa Rica came and asked my father to go back with them. They wanted my father to make a good impression so that Costa Rica could ask Injun for a good deal of money for our island. When he was in Costa Rica, he was asked to cut his hair and wear a suit so that he wouldn't seem simple to the Injun people.
Spared no expense. Hammond, the man who made all this, he runs Injun. It's something he always says. He'll spend whatever it takes to make the park a success.
So, he spent it all on the dinosaurs.
Yeah.
Not on my people. I felt as I feel now. My father was different. I knew him, but some part of him had been lost.
I'm sure it was a very difficult time for your father.
I know he wanted what was best for our people. He was too trusting. They took advantage of him.
It's kind of sad.
He sounds like a brave man. Were you too close?
When we were on the island, yes. We were always together. My father was an awa, a spiritual healer. He sang for Sibo, who created the earth. He was very important to our tribe. But after we left the island, he would not keep up the old traditions. He was always unhappy.
What is Sibo?
That mountain there. It is like a house, my father said. My people believe that the animals of the world built it. Before Injin. And my father and I would go to the ocean to fish. When I would swim in the ocean, my father would say, Nima! Little fish! Little fish, do not swim so far. I cannot catch you so far out. When Injin came to move us to Costa Rica, I became very angry with my father. Whatever he would tell me to do, I would refuse. But he would never be angry with me. He would say that I am a fish who would never eat the fisher's bait. He was right. To me, everything had a string attached.
You remind me of Jess. I mean, that's how it used to be with us before the divorce. I'd take her to the museums or to the zoo. She'd always climb up onto things, you know, such a climber. She can't not climb over things, into things. Climbed into a tiger pen once. With a live tiger. No, things haven't been the same since the divorce. Do you still blame him for everything?
No, I have forgiven him. I know to blame Injin now.
Yeah, those motherfuckers.
They always remind me of my stubbornness. I think I believe that's how I must always be. You know, no ties, no temptation. But then I had Atlanta and Mariquita. She is almost of an age where she will outgrow my protection. Young girls on the streets in my neighborhood, they get snatched up by local cartels, run drugs. Or worse, some just disappear. Now there is no choice. Everything I do for her. Now I am the fisher.
Okay, maybe this is enough.
I don't want to seem indifferent, but I really need to find Jess.
You're right. I'm not always so... Como se dice, talkative. Fine. Let's get moving then. All right, Jerry. Enough talk.
You know where we are?
I just said enough talk.
It's a difficult hike. Do you feel rested?
Hungry. A little thirsty, but I just want to get to Jess.
Good.
Shh. Shit. Oh, Lord.
Did you guess Dilophosaurus?
Hello?
That was actually the call.
Oh, that's the car.
Dinosaurs shared many features with modern-day birds. For instance, we now know that many theropod dinosaurs from the Jurassic period's vocal organs are just like modern birds. We are arriving at the fourth of seven lookouts along the tour. Your Jurassic Park tour vehicle will stop for 5 minutes to let you stretch your legs and take photographs of our animals. Next stop, the Jurassic Park Marine Facility and Aquarium.
Crappy car.
Would you look at this?
They look like feeder tanks. This could be a hatchery.
A hatcher what?
They're raising these fish to feed another animal, like at Marine World.
Like the killer whales?
Precisely.
That's a lot of fish. How many whales are they feeding?
I don't know. It looks like each of these tanks could feed 3 or 4 orcas per day.
Oh, you're a fish expert now.
I can make an educated guess.
Educated guess.
Look, there's a sign over there. It looks like a schedule or something.
This is a hatchery. That's the stocking schedule for the tanks.
Some tells me these fish aren't for feeding whales, huh, Doc?
No.
Hold up. I hear something. All clear.
Dad!
Jess! Oh, thank God. Are you okay? Are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Just, can we go home now?
I'm so glad you two are safe, Jerry. How did you manage to get here?
We climbed out of the tunnels through a service hatch near one of the tour routes. Luckily, someone left the tour program running. Thanks.
You mean...
Dr. Sorkin, the phones are not working.
I'm sorry?
There is no dial tone. You said the phones would be working here.
Oh, Hannah.
That's odd. My control terminal showed that the main lines here were active. Unless, of course, everything is controlled by the computer systems, even the phones. If the power outage outlasted the battery backups, then the system is probably just waiting to be booted up.
Get us to the phones, Doc. We don't have a lot of time.
Mr. Yoder, I refuse to be pushed around by you any longer.
Look, this isn't a day trip. If we don't contact InGen and get another helicopter out here for you all, the next flight over the island is going to be a wing of B-52s carrying holy hellfire.
Oh,
what?
That's right, Doc. You're going to murder all your precious little pets and sink this island into the Pacific.
Jesus.
Dios mío. That's what you meant by Ground Zero?
Yeah, that's right.
Why didn't you tell me earlier? This is my home.
What do you mean, your home? I didn't tell you earlier because I thought we'd be off the island by now.
This island is the ancestral home of her people.
Wait, what is Dr. Sorkin doing?
What the hell?
Laura?
What the hell are you doing, bitch?
Wait, what are you...
Where is she going?
I don't know.
Great.
This rotunda, it's where the control room is. She's going to the phones without us.
Damn it, get that elevator back up here!
Why do I have to do everything?
Wow, they've really made a lot of progress in construction here. Paleozoic, huh? Well, most of the specimens here aren't really from the Jurassic period anyway. Paleozoic. From oldest to newest. Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian.
Permian.
What is that supposed to be?
I don't know. Looks like a mosasaur.
Mosasaur?
Mosa what? It looks kind of scary.
Well, it's sort of a sea lizard of sorts. You think of a big moray eel with a crocodile head.
Croco eel?
Croco eel.
Sounds charming.
Don't worry. There are no sea creatures on my list of park animals.
Then what are all the feeder fish for?
Yeah, good
feeder
question.
Fish.
Yeah, we came through a big room filled with tanks of fish. Laura said they were for feeding other animals, like whales.
Well, let's not jump to any conclusions.
We should. There's probably dino whales here.
I'll be over by the info desk, okay?
Yeah, Dad.
Information. Sure could use some now.
Information.
Oh, good. Instructions. Insert operator's key into key slot. Okay. Etc., etc. Code expires in 24 hours. Morning operations reset procedure. Turn key counterclockwise to input notch and hold for 3 seconds. Keypad will reset and beep 3 times. Turn key clockwise to reset. Enter previous code, then new code. Huh, that's easy enough.
Yeah, doesn't seem hard.
Huh, very clever. Looks like they're using numbers from the dates of the Paleozoic era as daily key codes. Okay, so the plaque for the Paleozoic era preceded the oldest period at the display. Maybe the sequence doesn't start at the beginning of the week. Today is Saturday. I need Friday's code.
I don't know what Friday's code is. I like this one. This one's nice. I'll take this one. Permian.
Permian. Sounds right. Okay, best guess. Is everything all right between you two?
Mind your own business and get the elevator running.
I wasn't talking to you.
No more fighting. Things are bad enough as they are.
Why can't I talk to her? Jesus Christ.
I need to get the elevator running.
Duh. We'll get over there. Oops. One more time. Jesus fucking Christ, I don't know how to do this shit. What the fuck are you one more time. This thing is broken. I'm serious. This thing is fucking broken. Okay. Put 3 seconds. There you go.
9251. All right.
Yes.
New code. Let's keep it simple.
000. Let's go, people.
Hey, don't open that. Are you crazy? Someone will see.
Relax.
See what?
Shit.
Damn it, you careless idiot.
What was that thing? Some kind of spy gear?
Totally.
Yeah, that's right. Top secret. In fact, if you tell anyone about it, I'll have to kill you.
Damn!
You won't
don't
lay
you...
a finger on her.
I was just kidding around.
Everyone, I got the elevator working.
About time.
What's going on here?
Nothing. We're all cool. Jeez, get over it. Let's go. We don't got all day.
Let's go already.
Dad, my ears.
Attention.
What's going on?
The Lagoon Rotunda and Spectacular is housed in a
they're going down.
Underwater environment. We suggest you pinch your nose and push your breath to equalize your ears while we descend. If you experience any lasting discomfort or feel unusually giddy, let your attendant know immediately.
Giddy?
They're talking about nitrogen narcosis. It's a risk of breathing pressurized air.
What makes you the expert?
I saw it in a movie.
Sure you did.
Whoa! Is that where we're going?
I think so.
That's nice.
My God. Wasn't expecting any of this.
This is so cool.
Careful. I'll lead.
Cool. Look at that.
I want to speak with Hammond.
Oh.
No, this can't wait. Can you connect me to Mr. McGuire?
How
no,
the hell
Peter
did she get telephone connection down underwater?
Please
doesn't
hurry.
Make any sense.
No, look. This is Dr. Lawrence.
Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
Park. I am still on the premises. Get me somebody. Mr. Parker, I do not need rescuing. I do not want the bombing waylaid. I want
it's
it
locked
stopped.
From the inside.
What? It's not contaminated. This is a wildlife preserve. These animals are not diseased. They are extremely endangered.
Oh, no one can do anything.
You're not listening to me!
Hey, Dad! This looks like an intercom up here.
What? Where? Good find, honey. Laura, it's me, Jerry. Laura?
Jerry, I hear you, and I'm glad you're here. This is gonna be a lot easier now.
Explain, bitch!
We're gonna stop the bombing, Jerry. This island must be preserved.
I don't think it's gonna happen. Oh, shit. What the fuck?
I have taken the remaining survivors hostage.
No
way. There are
way.
Four others, three Americans and one Costa Rican. I won't let them go unless the plans to bomb the island are completely rescinded.
You have no fucking
right. No right to hold us like this.
Rights are just an ideological construct.
Oh, shut up.
Turn this into a philosophy debate.
What rights do the dinosaurs have? Don't they have the right to survive? Do their rights outweigh any of ours?
It is not our rights versus theirs. Our dinosaurs are phantoms. Majestic as they may be, alive as they may be. We brought them into a world that is no longer prepared for them.
Exactly.
We have a responsibility to keep them isolated and under rein for the safety of our ecosystem. It's not rights, it's responsibility.
And we have a responsibility to preserve our creations and allow them a chance to survive on their own terms.
They had that chance.
Billy, will InGen stop the bombing?
Doubt it. InGen is not the one dropping bombs, it's the US military, and the contingency is based around a biohazard cover story. She may just be delaying the inevitable.
If you don't offer me some sort of guarantee that the island will be preserved, I will have to escalate matters.
Damn.
This is lunacy! Fine, put the military on the phone. Hello? Hello? You want to see contamination of the global ecosystem?
Listen to them.
Laura, please, listen to them. Listen to reason. You're being irrational.
Nature is irrational. Rationalizations haven't gotten results. I think it's time to put matters back in nature's hands.
What the fuck are you talking
Laura,
about?
Laura, there are other options here. Holding us against our will to save the dinosaurs is only one poorly thought out solution. You're smarter than that, Laura.
I know, Jerry. I know what I'm doing. I clearly expressed the consequences of threatening this island. I scored a line in the sand that has been ignored and trampled over by InGen, by the government, and now I exercise my resolve.
You see, what are you gonna do?
I'm going to free the Mosasaur.
Are you mad? A land dinosaur paddling to the mainland is one thing. But you're talking about releasing an apex predator into over 70% of the global ecosystem.
It's only one. It can be recaptured.
Only one?
Before it eats the last of the humpbacks?
Oh, don't be dramatic.
Laura, don't.
She's the bad guy now. Jesus. No fucking
Plan
way.
Plan B.
Yes. Part one.
I'm sorry, Jerry. For the sake of this island and the scientific treasure it holds, I have been forced to take an action.
It's not too late. We can reverse this.
No. I locked the system down. There's nothing you can do.
Oh,
I've
shut up.
The gates and the Mosasaur is free to leave.
Laura, you have to...
No, Jerry. This isn't up for debate. We have to show...
Oh, damn. That's what happened when you tried to save a dinosaur.
Damn it! What were you thinking?
All right, everybody, be cool.
Be cool?
Stay away from the window.
A lady just died.
That's right. What? You want an I told you so? I don't know about you, but I came here to make a phone call. Hello? This is William Yoder, ID 4122. Put me through to Haskell. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The U.S. Embassy. Report as follows. The island is completely overrun. Alpha team killed in action, save one, myself. Bravo team killed in action. Two helicopters disabled. Two civilian casualties. I have access to a seaworthy boat and I will evacuate the remaining survivors. Yes, sir. The military may proceed. 90 minutes. Understood, sir.
What's with him?
What's happening? Who did you call?
Ghostbusters.
That's far enough.
What?
What?
You're not coming with me. There's going to be a tragic accident, Jerry.
You son
Nina,
of a
we
bitch.
We have everything we need. We're finishing this without them.
What?
Don't. Oh.
No.
What do you mean, no? We've got an agreement, remember?
Our agreement doesn't involve killing Jerry and Jess.
What's going on?
I'm sorry, Jerry. I was sent here to retrieve dinosaur embryos from InGen.
I don't understand. You're a corporate spy?
Yes.
Damn it, Nima! I trusted you!
It's not like that. Yoder took the can. He wants it for himself. I'm trying to help you and Jess.
What can?
A can of shaving cream. It has a compartment to smuggle the embryos off the island.
Damn it, Nima. You're blowing it!
No, you are. Oscar put his faith in you. He may have been a devil, but he wore his sins on his arm for everyone to see. You are just a mask with nothing behind it.
No, you can't do this! Don't you care? Don't you care about Oscar or Decap?
You son of a bitch.
Enough. Everyone stay back. I'm gonna give you a sporting chance here.
Billy,
once
wait.
Once I let go of the spoon, there ain't no coming back.
Don't do this!
Run!
Nah, he lost the can. Shit.
Come on, get up!
This sucks.
Is anybody hurt? Is everyone all right?
You mean, besides being trapped in this bubble by that desgraciado, we're as good as dead.
Don't say that. Somebody might, somebody will come for us.
No, oh, Jerry. Yoder left us here. He'll take the boat and not tell anyone about us.
Maybe he won't take the boat.
He has the canister. He knows where the boat is.
He, doesn't have the canister.
What?
I'm sorry. I promise not to steal anymore.
Okay,
but
that one's a freebie.
Jerry, look!
Oh, great. Just great.
Why is it flooding?
Must be the damage to the door. We're losing air pressure. This place will flood right up to the highest hole in the room. Damn it! Even if we could open the door against the pressure, the whole rotunda is flooded. There's nowhere to go.
Wait a second. I remember.
Maybe there still is a way out. If we swim.
Swim? We'll make it 20 feet with that Mosasaur swimming around.
Maybe. Look at that pipeline. It leads out of this lagoon. There are caves at the far end. Those caves connect to others that lead back to the beaches. We use the pipeline as cover.
And you think we can hold our breath the whole way?
Dad, look! There's diving gear!
No. We don't know the first thing about scuba diving.
I do.
What?
We have to distract the Mosasaur. Figure something out and meet us back down here.
Scuba diving? Oh, come on. How could this be so complicated? I don't know thing one about diving.
Dad, don't mess with the mixture valve. They're all preset.
Since when do you know about diving?
Remember those lessons you wouldn't let me take?
Did your mother override my decision?
Duh.
Actually, Steve bought me lessons. It was a secret.
Mom's boyfriend.
Yeah. If it's any consolation, I got grounded and Steve slept on the couch for a week.
I'll be right back. Feeder program. Hatchery B, Pool 4. That looks like the one scheduled for today's feeding. That ought to keep it busy.
For now. Damn, looking good.
Okay, hon, what do we do?
Dad, I changed my mind. These are rebreathers and I've never actually used one. I'm not ready for this.
Hey, you can do this.
No! What if something goes wrong? I don't want to do this. I don't want anyone else to get hurt.
Oh. I love you.
Jess, I know I don't say this enough, but I love you. Maybe I seem so overbearing, but it's because Sarah got away from me. And I don't want the same thing to happen with us. But right now, all that matters is that we get through this. Everything else, we can work that out later. It's small stuff compared to this.
I just don't want you to go away. I'm so tired of you always going away.
I know, honey, but I'm here right now, and I'm not gonna leave you alone. I'll be here with you all the way. Now, what's the diver signal for okay?
It's universal, duh.
Right. Well, I promise to signal you whenever you check on me, okay?
I'm scared.
As scared as that time you accidentally walked into Uncle Wallace's room while he was washing his nose?
It was so gross. I didn't know it was, like, prosthetic.
Okay, Jess, you ready?
Yeah, let's do this.
So, how do these things work?
Well, these are closed-circuit rebreathers. They look custom-designed. This is the regulator. It's built into the mask. It wants to help you breathe. Don't fight it. And don't hold your breath.
Okay, Don't hold my breath.
The tank is small, maybe 15 minutes of air.
Is that
15?
Enough?
But it recycles the air you exhale. It should work for about 45 minutes. Try not to freak out. You use air faster. You might even mess up the CO2 scrubbers.
That sounds bad.
CO2 poisoning is totally bad.
Totally.
That's it. The suit's mostly automated. It'll keep you, like, buoyant and manage your oxygen. Oh, and try to swim casual.
Swim casual?
Don't spaz out. It attracts sharks.
What about Mosasaurs?
I think it's the
same. Probably them, too. Turn around.
Damn. It's kind of cool that the game, that this part of the game goes underwater. It doesn't do that in the movies. 1, 2. Oops. Come on. Thank you. Oh my god. She's stuck. She's totally stuck. It's making noises. Ugh. This is taking a long time. Jesus Christ. Come on. For helvede. Shit, it's coming back, it's coming back, it's coming back! Oh shit. That is. Yeah. Ooh. Jesus. For helvede, man. Come on. Goodbye, Krago Yu. Damn. That was kind of cool.
Look, by the lighthouse.
Yes, that must be it.
Did they have their clothes under those swimming suits? I don't know. I don't want to ask questions.
Wait! I don't see anyone on it.
Maybe a dinosaur ate them. Maybe Billy ate them.
Maybe somebody.
Oh! Well, well, well. Fortune smiles upon the brave.
Hey, Dad!
I thought I'd worked everything out. Hadn't accounted for our little thief here. Well played, Jess. Well played.
Did you know where I was?
I was sure I had buried my ticket off this island at the bottom of the sea. But lo and behold, you slippery sons of bitches survived.
You a son of bitches, bitch.
Wait. Did you swim out of there?
You bastard. What will your bosses think when they learn that you tried to murder us?
But they won't learn about that. Because one way or another, you're not gonna tell them. I just don't know how we got to this point, Nima. You were the last one of my kind I thought I could trust.
Oh, shut up.
It didn't start out that way, but we had worked out a mutually beneficial deal! But now, I don't even have that. All that's left for me is that damn canister. Now hand it over, Missy. Nice one. Almost hurt.
I was supposed to.
You know, things don't have to be this way. We'll kiss and make up and share this payout just like we planned.
I won't kiss you. You're an ass.
You talk too much, Yoder. Are we gonna fight or have boring conversation?
Oh, come on. Don't make this easy for me. Come on, Nima. You're a merc, just like me. You got bills to pay? Are these two really worth all this?
Yeah.
I am not like you. You are a monster. Worse than the things on this island. No more talk.
Let's
shut up
fight.
And fight.
Yeah. Okay, that wasn't so good. Sorry. Come on. Ow. Jesus, that's gotta hurt. Yeah, don't do anything. Just sit there and just look. Don't do anything at all. I'm just doing all the work. Jesus fucking Christ. Come on. Yes. Oh, no.
Oh, there we go. Is that the little thing we're fighting over?
I can't. God damn it.
What's that? I can have it? Why so generous all of a sudden?
What the hell? Oh, mad.
You want to be the hero?
Yes.
You want to break our deal?
Do you feel that?
It's the...
Oh my god. Stop!
You want to make new friends?
It's the motherfucking...
Yoder! And Nima, I don't like
it. T-Rex. I really don't think standing still would hold it, but whatever. Just stand still. Yeah, I'm totally gonna do it. Goodbye, Ken. Some nasty shit. Come on. Damn, he's like tossing. Come on. Talking about. Damn, that T-Rex.
We made it.
Lost the can.
Me, the whole world is better off without that can.
Guys,
not me, Joey. Not my daughter.
Guys.
Nima. I made a promise. I'll figure something out. Come back to Dallas with us. We'll find a way to get you and your Marikita.
Guys!
What?
How much did you say those embryos were worth?
Whoa. Oh, that's great, man. That's awesome. So if you choose the emeralds, you... Yeah. But that's still awesome. It's still awesome. Damn. This game is awesome. 10 out of 10. Love it. And that's the end of Jurassic Park Telltale game. I really like it. It's really good. One thing I had problem was this is the game where it's really difficult to not die. I died a lot of times, so but it's really good. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and leave a comment. I'll see you guys in the next episode or whatever I'm gonna play in the future. Peace.